Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Ada Ogo. In this channel, I talk about skincare. Every day, I work towards having a healthy skin using healthy skincare products. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please, please subscribe. I dedicate today's video to the newbies. You know, the skincare newbies, those starters, those beginners of skincare. Okay, today's video, I want to talk about chemical exfoliation, and I'm making this video for those beginners, those who do not know their left to right when it comes to chemical exfoliation. When you just begin a skincare journey, because skincare is actually a journey, when you just start, just like me in the past, it was very overwhelming. Sometimes there is little or no information out there to guide you. So I'm making this video to actually create a guide for those beginners who do not know what chemical exfoliation is and how to use them. When you use chemical exfoliation, you are trying to achieve a brighter, beautiful skin, but then when you do not do it the right way, you're going to end up ruining your progress. You're going to end up ruining your skin. And one of the things that make people just go overboard when it comes to chemical exfoliation is the fact that there is little or no information out there guiding people on what to do. So I am here for you guys as a pro, as a chemical exfoliation pro. So let's get into the video. The question right now is, as a beginner, what chemical exfoliant should you use? The answer here is anyone that suits your skin. And there is no how you're going to know chemical exfoliation that suits your skin until you've tried them all. If you're just a newbie in chemical exfoliation, I want you to know that you do not use all the exfoliants at once. You do not use glycolic acid, lactic acid, mandelic acid, salicylic acid at once. No. You using all these things at once is going to ruin your skin. Number one tip I want to give you when you are just starting off chemical exfoliation is to get one acid at a time. What I mean one acid at a time is that get a single acid. Do not get, like, for example, if you want to get lactic acid. Do not get lactic acid that has glycolic acid in it, that has salicylic acid, you know, blend of acids. No. That way, you don't actually know which chemical exfoliant will react negatively to your skin. But when you start with one, for example, when you start with lactic acid, if lactic acid reacts to your skin negatively, you'll be able to spot that, oh, my skin is reacting to lactic acid. My skin does not like or tolerate lactic acid. But when you go and get a chemical exfoliant that has lactic acid in it, salicylic acid in it, glycolic acid and mandelic acid in it, of course, you do not know the one your skin is reacting negatively or bad to, because you're using all these acids at once. For example, let me show you something. This one from Polar Choice, this 10% AHA from Polar Choice, it has lactic acid in it, it has glycolic acid in it, and it has malic acid in it. For example, if you're a beginner, you do not want to use this particular acid. It has 10% of all these, that is AHA. It is a combination of AHAs, and we know that AHAs help to smoothen wrinkles and fine lines. It is written here, but you do not want to use all these at once. You want to start with single acid products. For example, the one from The Ordinary. The Ordinary makes single acids. This one, lactic acid from The Ordinary, is just lactic acid. Okay, it is just lactic acid. So when you get lactic acid, for example, and you're using this and it reacts negatively to your skin, you know, oh, my skin is reacting badly to lactic acid. You're going to start with one acid at a time. Even though now I can use lots of acid as I want, I can use glycolic acid, I can use mandelic acid, I can use salicylic acid. I have all of them depending. But when you're just starting out, you do not need all this. You need to concentrate on one. If your issues are breakouts, then you want to start with salicylic acid because that is what it does. It helps with unlocking clock pores and help with breakouts. So you want to start with it and see if your skin can actually tolerate salicylic acid before thinking of buying mixed acids. You know, you might want to start with mandelic acid also. When I started using acids in 2018, I started with salicylic acid, the one from Paula Choice, and the person that customized my routine almost actually ruined my skin for me. You do not start with too many actives at a time. The person that actually customized my routine gave me cleanser that had salicylic acid in it. I was just a beginner, so I do not know. I'm not supposed to do all these things. And this person is an OG in skincare. I don't know why sometimes they just do these things. Okay? This cleanser I had there that she gave to me has salicylic acid in it. She gave me this one from Paula's Choice. And I was supposed to use, she told me to use this morning and night, every single day. You get me? Then she even added tretinoin. As someone that is just starting out, you added tretinoin, salicylic acid, and salicylic acid cleanser. And she definitely gave moisturizer. Okay? I wasn't using moisturizer then. So you need to be careful of who is customizing your skincare routine for you. So what I'm trying to say in essence is that do not start up with lots of acids. Do not start off with lots of chemical exfoliants. Start with one. Okay, start with one. Then with time, if you've used lactic acid and you feel, oh, after 1 month that your skin has tolerated it, you can do with it, then you might want to try mandelic acid. From there, you might want to try salicylic acid. From there, you might want to try glycolic acid. And see, while trying all these acids, then you will know which one actually is having a negative impact on your skin. That way, when you want to buy a chemical exfoliant that has lots of AHA mixed in it, with salicylic acid mixed in it, you will actually now know if you should buy them or not, or if you should continue with one single product, then keep alternating them on different days. I don't know if you get what I'm trying to say. So do not just try to use or experiment all the acids at once. Do not do that. Another mistake you should not do as a beginner, just like I just said, that someone that started my routine for me had me use lots of acid, including cleanser that has salicylic acid in it. So if you're just starting out, do not use a cleanser that has any exfoliant in it. Then come out from the bathroom after your shower and apply your chemical exfoliants. No, you don't do that. If you use a cleanser that has chemical exfoliants in it, just avoid applying any other thing in your routine that has any kind of chemical exfoliants in it. For example, you use a cleanser that has lactic acid in it after having your shower. When you come out, seriously, just go straight to other hydrating, moisturizing skincare products and skip using any of this lactic acid, mandelic acid, glycolic acid, because this thing will jam your skin, and instead of making your skin, it's not going to ruin your skin. So you have to be careful when it comes to chemical exfoliant. It's very beautiful for your skin. It's very nice for your skin. It helps to make your skin look youthful, but when you go overboard, you're going to end up ruining your skin. Another thing you do not want to do is using your chemical exfoliant, whether lactic acid, mandelic acid, either of them, whether salicylic acid, any of your chemical exfoliant. You do not want to be using them every day. If you're just starting, just use it once a week at night. At least for the first 2 to 3 weeks, use it once a week to see how your skin adjusts to it. Because if your skin hasn't adjusted to you using it once a week, you using it twice or three times a week, it's just you being very wicked to your skin. So listen to your skin. If it is drying at the first week, try to moisturize more. Try to get it to a place where your skin is already used to it before you can actually start using it 2 to 3 times a week. You know, when it comes to chemical exfoliant, it's actually, it is actually, I see it as a marathon. It's something you're going to use for a long time. So you're going to start easy, slowly. Just keep seeing it as marathon. You know, when it comes to marathon, you're going to start very slow. That is how it is when it comes to chemical exfoliation. Another thing you don't want to do as a beginner is jumping to 20% when you've not even used 7% acid or 7% or 10% acid. Okay, if you want to use lactic, if you're starting with lactic acid, for example, especially when you've not used any kind of acid before, you want to start with at least 5%. The likes of salicylic acid, no matter what, you do not want to use more than 2% on your skin. Glycolic acid, as a starter, you do not want to use more than 7% on your skin. Know these things. Know how many percent you should start with. Okay? As a baby, you have to crawl before you walk, right? You walk before you start running. So it's the same thing when it comes to acid. You don't just go overboard immediately, or because you hear someone say, use this acid. Do not do that. Start easy, start slowly, and your skin will thank you. Trust me, chemical exfoliation is one of the best things that can happen to your skin. If you do it rightly, it's one of the best things. It can change your skin forever. It has changed mine, and it can change yours. So these are the tips you should have at the back of your mind as a beginner. Remember all I said, make sure you start with single acid. Do not start with combinations of acid at once. Also remember, do not use a cleanser that has acid in it and you come back from the shower and use any serum or any toner that has acids in them. It's going to be so overwhelming on your skin. Your skin is going to react in a very bad way. Your skin is going to fight you, okay? Also remember to start slowly. Do not use your acid every day. Also, remember, at the back of your mind, this tip should always be at the back of your mind. Use the lowest percent possible as you're starting. With time, you will see that, yes, you can actually go higher. But as a starter, just use the lowest percent possible. Seriously, when I first started, I wish someone told me this thing. Because when I first started, my skin became so irritated. If you touch my skin, sometimes it's so drying. Because the person that started my routine did not do the right thing. I can't start someone's routine with the first time the person is starting a skincare journey, you're starting the person with salicylic acid cleanser, salicylic acid toner, and tretinoin with no moisturizer. So as you're starting, always remember to moisturize your skin. Always moisturize your skin, guys. Apply your acid, wait 10 minutes more, then apply your moisturizer, always moisturize, and also wear your sunscreen. You're going to ruin the effort you're making on your skin if you do not wear sunscreen. Wear sunscreen, guys. Once you're going out, me, Onami does sometimes, I try to draw the curtains like you see here, so I do not wear sunscreen most times when I'm home. But once I'm going out, guys, I'm always wearing my sunscreen. So wear your sunscreen. As long as you're wearing your sunscreen and you're using your acids or your chemical exfoliants the right way, trust me, you have no issues. Trust me, your skin will glow. Let's glow together, guys. If you have any questions, please ask in the comment section. The comment section is open for you guys. Ask questions, comment, share your opinion. Make the comment section interactive. Let's chat in the comment section. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. And I hope this video helped someone who is just starting out and the person is confused. Okay? Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe. Subscribe. Thank you. Share this video if possible. Thank you guys. See you next time. Bye.